you've reached the point of no return. Hey everyone, Templar74 here with another Yu-Gi-Oh video, and today's Yu-Gi-Oh video is going to be my thoughts and impressions regarding the latest episode of Yu-Gi-Oh VRAINS, episode 110, I Sad Frustration. And I gotta be honest with you guys, this episode title really says it all about this week's episode. It was very emotional, very impactful, and there was a twist in this episode that I have to admit even I did not see coming. But we'll talk about all of that soon enough. So, at risk of further rambling, let's move on to the actual episode. So the episode begins with Ai's confrontation with Zaizen, and Zaizen realizes that if Ai is here, that means he infiltrated the Soltec plane, which is flying 12,000 meters above Den City, roughly about 60,000 feet. And Zaizen's first question to Ai is the crew all right? And Ai is like, whoa, who do you think I am? The crew's fine. And he shows Zaizen a visual of Hayami, who is now unconscious on the ground. However, Ai assures Zaizen that she's fine. She's just taking a nap. However, Ai goes real dark here, and he tells Zaizen, if you refuse to duel me for that code key, I'll just crash the plane. And he even shows Zaizen and Blue Maiden that he does have complete control of that aircraft. So it goes really dark there, and this really unsettles both Blue Maiden and Zaizen. At this point, the final Pandora appears, much to Ai's frustration. He's like, I thought I already destroyed you. And Pandora's like, well, I'm the final one, and I've got data on all of your duels, etc. So Ai is basically undeterred by this, and he gets the duel underway, even offering Zaizen a handicap by letting Blue Maiden duel with him, against Ai. So the duel begins against these three, but not before Ai puts on some finishing touches for the duel. Ai brings in these visuals of Playmaker, Soulburner, and Revolver, patches them in so that they can see the duel, and he also relays this to Kusanagi. He sends a feed to Kusanagi so he can see the duel as well, and it's at this point Robopi also appears and announces that he's going to watch his big bro duel, and Ai praises the idea, says it's brilliant, and the duel finally gets underway with everybody watching. And Blue Maiden goes first. She does a continuous summon and brings out her Link monster, Link 3, Marbled the Rock, and 2 set cards. So it's at this point we learn that she is in fact still using Aqua's Marionette deck, and even Ai points that out. And Blue Maiden's like, of course I'm still using this deck. It's my most important deck. And so Ai even goes so far as to praise her and says that Aqua would be really happy that you're using this deck. And we see Ai make his first move, and Ai manages to Link Summon Dark Knight and Igonister Island. He manages to bring that card out as well. And we learn a little bit more about these At Igonister cards of his. We learned that the yellow one, Pickery, is representative of lightning. We learned that the fire one is representative of flame. We learned that the water tribute of that card, Igonister, is representative of aqua. So these cards really do symbolize Ai's emotions and his feelings for his lost friends. And we also see Ai bring out the Ignis's most powerful weapon, because as Dark Knight's out and he brings out another Link monster, Fire Phoenix, Ai proclaims that he is now going to play the Ignis's most powerful weapon, their most powerful card. Ai brings it out, and it is none other than Lightning's card, Judgment Arrows. So Ai brings out Judgment Arrows, and everybody's just stunned that this card shows up. Revolver even goes so far as to say, I thought that card was destroyed with lightning, and Playmaker is dumbfounded. He's like, you're carrying out Lightning's wishes, Ai? And even Soulburner goes so far as to say, since he played Judgment Arrows, that evil card, the card that represents the war between the Ignises, there is no returning back, Ai. You are evil. You will be destroyed. There is no redemption for you. So pretty much at this point, Judgment Arrows is the line that Ai has crossed. He's never going to be able to cross it again, according to Soulburner. And you can even feel that emotion echo within Revolver, and Playmaker's just kind of taken back that Ai would even use this evil card that represents the War of the Ignis. And when Judgment Arrows comes out, Ai launches attacks against Blue Maiden, and Blue Maiden is able to stop one of the attacks, but with Marionette's Wave, the trap card. However, she's unable to stop a second one because Ai uses a quick play spell, timed technique, and it allows Ai's Dark Knight to attack basically unimpeded, because what it does is it banishes all of Blue Maiden's hand until the end of the turn, which means that she can't activate Marbled Rock's effect to stop damage. So I's able to go in with Dark Knight, destroy Marbled the Rock, and ultimately knock both the Zizens down to just 1900 life points in just one strike. And with that strike, however, the turn ends, Blue Maiden's hand returns, and it's at this point Blue Maiden asks I a fundamental question here. Why must we fight? We're all feeling the same sadness. You failed to protect your friends, the Ignis. I failed to protect Aqua. It's all the same sadness. Why must we fight? And I is infuriated by this. This pushes him over the edge that he's comparing a sadness, quote unquote, that Blue Maiden is feeling when she easily replaced Aqua to his sadness for being the last Ignis standing. And he even goes so far as to question the others about, well, did Miyu survive? Did Kusanagi's brother survive? Because I legitimately did care about those two. And when he hears they survived, he's like, that's great, but my friends are never going to survive. And so he's infuriated that Blue Maiden even went there, comparing these levels of sadness that he feels compared to what she feels. And so this is at this point when Zizen comes in. He steps in, and he offers an apology on behalf of Soltec and himself to I, basically saying, as chief executive of Soltec and as an employee of the company that created the Ignis, I'm sorry for everything that you've gone through. Because he does feel legitimately sad for I. He feels sorry for I that he lost all of his friends. And Revolver even enlightens us a little bit. Revolver goes on to say that free will, the key to free will is to be able to harness your emotions to get up and move forward. And if you can't do that, free will is uncontrollable. And it looks like I has fallen into that trap where his emotions became uncontrollable, therefore his free will is no longer controllable, and this is where we're at now. So even Revolver adds some enlightenment on what's going on with I here. It's like one big psychology lesson. However, I is in no interest, or has no interest, in an apology from Zizen or Soltec, and he basically tells Zizen, I have no need for an apology, get on with the duel. And so Zizen is, at this point, he puts on his serious hat, because he also points out that as chief executive of Soltec, his job is to protect all of his employees and all of their families from any danger that I would bring into the company. And I just kind of taunts him. He's like, fine then, protect them, Zizen, bring it on. And so Zizen does so. He brings out a continuous summon of his 10 dangle monsters using their flip effects, and he's able to destroy Dark Knight and lose, and make I lose 100 life points, because even Judgment Arrow's attack boost, it's not enough to stop his 10 Dangles monster's attack points. His 10 Dangle Hound, of course, gained so many attack points that it was able to destroy Dark Knight and ultimately cause I to lose 100 life points. And while this is a celebration for Blue Maiden and Zizen, because they've managed to break through, they managed to deal I some damage, I's like, you're cheering over 100 mere points of damage. And so it's at this point they realize the duel's not over, and the two Zizens bring out another Link Summon together. They bring out Link 3, 10 Dangle, Acute Cerberus, Zizen's Ace Monster, according to Revolver. However, Playmaker is quick to correct them. He's like, no, this is their Ace Monster, the symbol of the brother and sister bond that Blue Maiden and Zizen share. And that's where the episode leaves off. So yeah, like I said, this episode was very emotional, very impactful. You could feel it. Everybody was pulling in onto the emotions that I is feeling here. Even Revolver had something to contribute to this. Although he's not necessarily feeling sympathy for I because he still hates the Ignis, he does manage to show us why, and he understands why I is doing this to an extent. However, whether Revolver really cares or not about what happens to I is still up in the air. But yeah, with that being said, the episode was very emotional, very impactful. Overall, I give this episode a 9 out of 10. It was a very well done episode, and I got to admit, my favorite part of the episode was the part where we saw the reunion between Aoi and Miyu there. It was really great to finally see that moment. That was something I've been wanting Vraines to do since they introduced Miyu's character with Aqua. So seeing that there, that was the cherry on top for this episode, in my opinion. Like I said, 9 out of 10. And Judgment Arrows, I got to admit, Judgment Arrows did not see that come, and I'm very interested to see how I is going to make use of Judgment Arrows throughout the rest of this arc, because now it's inevitable that he's going to use it in every single duel. But with all of that being said, everybody, those were my thoughts about this week's episode. But as always, in the comments section down below, let me know what you guys thought about this week's episode. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Did you think it was just eh there? What were your thoughts? Just let me know in the comments section down below, because as always, I enjoy hearing from you. All right, everyone, as always, Templar74 signing off. Have a great day, everybody, and I'll talk to you all next time. Goodbye, everybody.